Hello, welcome on Al Control. Tatiana here. I'm a French game designer and artist. I make alternative controller games and playful installations. Today's video should have been a making of my new project. Unfortunately, the art residency that was supposed to host this project in June has been postponed to September for obvious reasons. So I had to change my plans, and I thought it could be a good idea to explain what's an art residency and more generally, where are Alt Control made, what environments are suitable for creating Alt Control games. There are five main environments in which Alt Control games are made. Of course, some are made at home, but the lack of space and tools can be a problem. So in that case, you can work in labs and workshops, places like Fab Labs, Hacker Spaces, and Biolabs. Personally, I mainly work in art residencies, but I also made some of my games during game jams. And finally, it wasn't a thing when I was a student, but nowadays you can make some at school. I love working in the comfort of my living room. I made most of my simplest controllers that way, like the one for Izukun. Over time, I came to be well equipped and can prototype most of my electronics on my couch, but it's nothing like Nicholas Roy's place, whose workshop and home is as amazing as his projects. My flat is quite small, so I often have to find places to work that have both a lot of space to exploit and specific machines that I need to build my installations. So I often work in Fab Labs, Media Labs, Hacker Spaces, and other kind of workshops where you find machining tools, mainly those with automated control, also known as CNC, computer numerical control. Some of these places will just ask you to pay to use the machines. Others are more in the open source culture and will ask you to share your work under a Creative Commons license and write a step-by-step guide for reproducing it. In these places, you'll usually find laser cutters, machines for turning, drilling, and milling, 3D printers, embroidery machines, and vinyl cutters. All these machines work with vector files. You can make those using Inkscape, an open source software often installed on the lab's computers, or Adobe Illustrator. In those workshops, you'll usually find basic hand tools and soldering stations, or even machine tools like drill presses. Some of these places also feature more uncommon tools, depending on their theme. Some are more dedicated to arts and crafts, and will feature screen printing presses, for example. Others are focused on chemistry or biology. They are sometimes called biolabs or biohack labs. Those have chemistry lab equipment like petri dishes and test tubes. These labs are ideal to make biotic games, a type of games based on the control of living things like paramecia or roaches. Some websites list labs around the world. I place one in the description below. I made all my most complex installations during art residencies. Art residencies, also called Artist in Residence program, are a time and space dedicated to work on a project organized by a residential art center. Each residency is different. It can be large or small, established or experimental, and it can last from few weeks to several months, sometimes up until a full year. Residencies usually provide a space to work in and the funds for the materials, sometimes pay hosting and travel fees, and even give per diem allowances. They usually take place in venues dedicated to culture or education. Since 2015, I've made most of my creations in art residencies. Magnesia was made at The Brain, a residency in Berlin organized by the Amaze Festival team. The game was made during a residency at the DigiArt Living Lab in Tunisia. Contre-Ciel was made in Strasbourg during the residency which gave rise to my first solo exhibit, and Intact was made during a residency in an abbey in the south of France. There are two main types of residencies, those dedicated to research and writing, and those dedicated to the production, the making of the work. From my experience, production residencies always end with a vernissage where the created work is exhibited. Sometimes the residency requires the artist to run some sort of educational events like a workshop or a lecture. I participated in some residencies during which I gave Alt Control workshops to kids. Those are my favorites. Before 2014, I made most of my Alt Control games during on-site game jams. The first versions of Atsuno, GPU, and Jeux de Main were made in jams. On-site game jams are events usually lasting 2 to 3 days, during which designers and developers gather together to make a game from scratch. Some developers also make Alt Control games during online game jams. Finally, some Alt Control games are made as students' projects at university during game design or game development courses. As I said, this wasn't really a thing when I was a student, but I've been teaching this a lot for the past 5 years. Here are the 45 Alt Control games made by students during my classes that are listed on Shake That Button. This will be the topic of an upcoming video, so I won't go any further here. So that's all for today. Hopefully I'll be able to show you the making of my new project in the next video. Thanks a lot for watching, and until next time, take care and be playful.